at all?
No.
Better make it quick, better make it quick. Hey. And welcome everyone into the Ronald B. Stafford Ice Arena, where this afternoon your Plattsburgh State Men's Cardinals hockey team faces off against the Eagles from Brockport in this SUNYAC conference game. Hello everyone, my name is Hans Hummerschlag, and I'm joined alongside my color commentator, Eli Perez. Eli, how are we doing today?
Well, I'm ready for another game of hockey, game number two here in the Ronald B. Stafford Arena. And you already know the vibes, Hans.
Yeah, and this Cardinals team, you know, they were at it last night. They're right back at it today. And let's get you guys down to the action. Shall we, Eli?
Yeah, shall we?
Let's go. And it'll be Brockport who wins the opening faceoff here at the Ronald B. So the Cardinals coming off that stellar 6-2 victory last night against the 8th-ranked Geneseo Knights. What a dominant performance that was, as Joshua Belgrave, who scored that empty net goal, looks just to dump it in to that Brockport zone.
Well, you know, it's the Cardinals showing why they're the number 3 seed in Division 3 and why they really deserve the number 1. And it's them trying to really end a 22-year drought and try to bring a national title back home.
Yeah, and, you know, for these Cardinals, that is going to be important. And it was like you were saying last night, Eli, you're looking for communication in this team, and we saw it last night. We'll see if that carries over into today, along with that great, fiery offensive momentum they have, as it is Jack Ring now who will play it up for Luke Jurasek, who moves it to Tio DiArdio, who his shot goes up, but it is gloved by Dylan Weimer.
Well, yeah, of course. Last night, the Cardinals had an amazing puck control and puck communication. Their passing was on track, it was accurate, and they got some good goals off of it, too.
And so now the Cardinals, looking a minute left, or a minute gone in this first period, looking at how their first good offensive chance. We'll see if they can do something here, as it's DiArdio to get that puck near the end boards. And Thomas looks to play that one, or Katrin looks to play that one high up, but his stick just a bit too high, and the ref tells him to lower that.
You know, high sticking up here.
So now it'll be Brockport to move it back into the Cardinals' offensive zone, and a nice takeaway here by the Golden Eagles. So now, as it'll be Roach against Ring, and Ring comes up with that one. Oh, and Butler's met by a Golden Eagle there. That's Ramaker's, and that's a hard collision now, but it's Luke Jurasek to DiArdio. Back to Jurasek, and his shot is just wide the glove side of Weimer. Here's Bulger now, but that puck can't reach Stockdale, and the Golden Eagles will have to clear it out.
The Golden Eagles 2-2 overall, 1-1 in conference play. They're struggling really in the beginning of the season here, trying to go back over 500.
Yeah, and if you're the Golden Eagles coming into this game, head coach Brian Dickinson, you want to set a tone early because you know that you're coming in as an underdog here in this one, and you know that if you're going to level out against this fiery Plattsburgh offense, your offense yourself and your defense has to get going very, very early.
No, yeah, and especially if you're trying to, if you're trying to outscore a number 3 ranked team, it's going to be a challenge for you, and that's what on Brockport's plate right now is trying to outscore Plattsburgh.
And you know when you come in the day, it's going to be a long day, so you're trying to shorten that as much as possible. As Brockport will play it around their own net, it's Galloway. And now Maxwell trying to make something happen, but Benson takes that puck off him, and Weimer will have to play it out to Ramakers. So, It is Maxwell now dumping it in. Galloway playing chase for the Golden Eagles. But it will be Sutherland and Benson now to play it out. And Benson's shot is covered right up by Dylan Weimer.
This is Weimer's fourth game. 4-for-4 for games played and start. And he's looking to try to improve his save percentage, which is at .876 this year.
Yeah, and if you're Dylan Weimer, not something you're that excited about, as you want to see that number starting with a 9.
Oh, and especially goals allowed as well. He has given up 11 goals this year to really start off.
See if Plattsburgh can get one here, and that one is so close by Tredowitz, but it just skates wide. And so now Belgrave will put that one in front, and that one off the pads of Weimer and outside. And so now the Eagles looking to make something here as Flansburgh puts Belgrave to the boards. And Rodrigo have to play it back out, but that puck skips off the stick of Flansburgh and goes down for an icing.
Flansburgh this year leading the team in 5 points and goals. So he's really the moneymaker right now for Brockport.
Flansburgh, he is their shooter, the freshman. Almost, you consider him a local kid. Saratoga Springs, not too far from Plattsburgh, as Butler's shot is glove side wide of Weimer.
He wanted to get away from home, really.
Yeah. Getting away and playing some good hockey for these Golden Eagles, as Ring will just have to dump that one in. But Katrin will give chase, but just not enough pace there for the kid from Middletown. And so now Ring will play it out, and that one just a bit too hard, as it'll move back into the neutral zone, and the Cardinals will have to reset here, and they'll look to make a change. So Cards quick back on that puck is Jurasek. Now it's Butler, and Butler's shot hits off a body in front. And Stockdale, great effort to keep that one. He gets it down to Jurasek and almost gets it over, but that one stopped in front again.
Some hard contact right now from the defensive side from Brockport.
And so now, here's Meredith, that puck taken off his stick by Diardio. And he will have to dump it down, and Maxwell will have to give play for Brockport. Maxwell now over to Bates. Gates taking that one in, but that one taken off his stick, and Thomas will play that one into the offensive zone. He's got Laney in front, but Laney not able to come away with that one because Thomas's pass unable to get through. So now Molina giving a great chase on that one, and Laney in front, and that one covered up by Weimer. So now it looks like Jake Laney for the Plattsburgh Cardinals. And someone from Brockport, it looks like that will be Harley getting into it there after that blown whistle.
Oh, you can see the frustration there, but it's like it's still early in the game. You know, you still got a lot of game to play, and it's still 0-0 for both sides.
Yeah, so we'll have to keep our eye on that. Jake Laney versus Andrew Harley here.
Well, the rivalry begins.
You got that right. And so Brockport will play it out now, as Rosenbaum looks to do something there. But we'll have a stoppage in play, and that puck will be sent back down. And we will have a face-off here in the Plattsburgh zone.
Cardinals, nothing new there in the face-off opportunity. And, you know, it's always a win-win when it comes to face-off.
And so 6:38 gone in the first period. Shot on goal advantage for the Cardinals. 4 shots on goal. Not a shot on goal yet for Brockport. We'll see if that changes here, and it does! And on the first shot on goal, Brockport scores! So it is Scott Raymakers with the goal there, as on their first shot of the game, that one skips up and off the shoulder of Eli Schiller and goes in the back of the net. So Brockport will have a 1-0 lead here. 14:20 left in this first period, and these Cardinals can't be happy about that one.
Well, you know, it's the second game for Eli Shiller, the former MVP of the SUNY Conference Finals. And it's an easy shot that could have been really, you know, unexpected right there from the Brockport side, as they really take a 1-0 advantage right now.
Yeah, it seemed like he had that one. He was tracking it well, just a little too tough off the stick there of Ramakers.
Well, that will be Eli's fourth goal allowed this season, making it 8 goals allowed in total for the Cardinals.
So now Weaver Vitale will have to get that puck for the Cardinals and get it up to Belgrave. Here comes Tredowitz with Breyer on his far side. But that one is taken off his stick by Rodrigue. But Belgrave now fighting for it in the corner. So Weaver Vitale up to Hogg. Hogg, now his shot is just wide. And Brockport will come away with this one. That pass too hard for Flansburgh. And now Hogg has to have some good puck control as he will hand it off to Weaver Vitale. Vitale over to Belgrave. Belgrave now getting that up. Tredowitz. Here's Breyer. Breyer's shot, and that's a great glove stop by the goalie Weimer.
Weimer getting opportunities right now for saves, and he's just boosting up his stats right now for this year. And it's a lost opportunities for the Cardinals as they are still cold offensively.
Yeah, early in this one, Dylan Weimer showing up and showing out a perfect 6-for-6 here.
Going for 100 saves this season already.
So it looks like we had a little bit of early movement there, so we'll restart that faceoff. And Galloway will win it for Brockport. And so Katrin will have to go all the way back in his own zone to pick up that one. But he's taken down there as Galloway will come away with it. And he'll try and look for someone on that far side. But Barbagallo has to reset. Barbagallo. And Galloway keeps that puck in for a stoppage of play.
Cardinals right now, defensively, they're looking like they're struggling. Offensively, Brockport has looking on fire out of the gates. And it's just something right now that the Cardinals have to figure out.
Yeah, Brockport needed to set that tone early, and they certainly have. As Ring will play it over to Singer. Singer back to Ring, and that pass a little too hard for Ring. As here comes Tilney, but Ring able to get that one at the last second. But Roach able to hit that one off the stick of Thomas. And now it looks like Plattsburgh scrambling here as some great defensive pressure from the Golden Eagles.
But the late penalty here called for the Cardinals as it's looking like it's tripping right there.
Yep, so Jack Ring for the Cardinals will be going to the box for 2 for tripping. So already seemingly back on their heels, the Cardinals now have to go on the penalty kill.
First power play that Brockport will have to take advantage of.
And so Galloway will win that faceoff. And he will play it back for Maxwell. Maxwell over. And now Flansburgh can't get a shot out in front. Good positioning because Baleen is there with a great stick defensively. Here comes Maxwell. Maxwell gets it over to Galloway. Galloway looking down low for Harley. And now that's back up to Maxwell and played over by Gates. And now that centering pass out in front from Harley cannot reach Flansburgh as Maxwell has to reset out in front.
It's a defensive wall right here during the power play as the Cardinals clear it, and it's like they never lost a defender or a player at all. It's like 5-on-5 even though it's 5-on-4.
Great defensive showing there as both teams make changes here. A minute left on this Brockport power play as Gates will leave it back for Sanchez. Sanchez now bringing it into the Cardinals offensive zone. He will leave it off for Flanberg, but we have a Vitale there with some great stick work defensively, and he will be able to clear it out to kill off another 10 seconds in this power play. Now, but here comes the goal scorer, Ramakers. Sanchez now, but that reaches Lanny. Lanny now, he's got Butler, but that puck is too hard, and Sanchez will play that one for the Eagles.
It's looking like the Cardinals are getting out beaten in speed, and it's really hard to see right now if the Cardinals can outmatch this defense.
And so 18 seconds left on this Brockport power play, and that puck will be shot down for an icing. So far on this Brockport power play, no shots on goal, and this Plattsburgh defense has been looking stellar. We'll see if this can switch momentum back in the favor of the Cardinals. And Ramekers wins that one for Brockport. And Rodrigue loses his edge there. And 5 seconds left on this Brockport power play as it comes to a close. So no shots on goal on that one. Plattsburgh has to be happy, and so does head coach Steve Moffitt.
Whoa, it's a vantage right there. Plattsburgh wasting the power play. Brockport missing an opportunity, and the Cardinals trying to really go for a breakout right now.
And so Ring trying to get something there going offensively, but a great defensive showing there by Chirico. And so here comes Bellina through neutral ice, but he loses that puck, and now Sarbaugh. Sarbaugh out in front, and Sarbaugh shot just goes wide, and it's a great pillow stop from Eli Schiller.
Schiller, he was almost going to give up an empty net, but he's still there to defend that goal and getting some extra support from his defense as well.
Schiller able to get that pad out just in time, and then a great glove stop there to get that one, stop it, reset this defense, and see if they can get this puck out, as there's another great stop by Schiller.
Schiller, after giving up that first goal, he's like, no, 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 not in my house.
He realized he made a mistake, and he has been solid, and we'll see if that can carry over through to the rest of this game. As Brockport there wins the faceoff, but no one home, and that one will skip in to the neutral zone.
Well, this is his second game playing, and he's just trying to look for some work this season.
And so we've Vitali able to beat Galloway on that puck, and right in front is the shot of Maxwell, but Eli Schiller covers that one up again.
The full pressure is on in the Cardinal zone, and Schiller is getting some work in.
Yes, Brockport all in front of the crease of Schiller, but Schiller looking good after giving up that first early goal. So now it's Maxwell and Jurasek for the faceoff, and Jurasek will win that one for the Cardinals, and Singer will play it around to Butler. But that shot from Bro off the point is blocked down in front. And so Singer now can't get that one away, as here's a chance for Galloway out in front, but Schiller, another great stop as that one gets through, but it goes off the post. So Butler now. Cardinals lucky didn't give up a second goal here. It's been looking dangerous as Jurasek tries to play that puck, and Diardio will chase Bro for that one. Bro now on the near boards. Butler trying to keep that one in the zone, but that one trickles out.
It's getting aggressive now, coming down to the final minutes of this first period.
And so Tilly trying to get to that one for Brockport, but it is Singer who comes up with it for the Cardinals.
Full pressure in the Cardinals zone right now as Brockport trying to get this.
Who will come away with it? And it's off the stick of Ramekers, but unable to get that shot cleanly. And so now a penalty coming here to Brockport as Diardio will play that one in the Cardinals offensive zone. And now there's a quick shot out by Katrin. And now here's Stockdale looking for something. Katrin out in front, his shot blocked up, and it is up high and wide. And so now the Cardinals will be heading to the power play, as it will be the goal scorer, Ramekers, who will be heading to the box for Brockport for two.
Oh, the Cardinals were trying to not go out with, they were trying not to take that penalty, trying to take that power play, trying to score at the last minute, but Brockport, you know, they got to take the penalty, and now there's a power play for the Cardinals.
And so we'll see if the Cardinals here can bring this one back to a square game.
5-on-4 advantage, the Cardinals really have to pop off on offense.
Right. So we'll see if Lanier can win this faceoff and get things started. But it will be Brockport who will win the faceoff, as that's Manny Sanchez getting that one. And so here's Thomas, and the Cardinals will get to work on this power play. Thomas now plays it to Lanny. Lanny over to Bulger. Bulger now on the point, over to Thomas, back to Bulger. Bulger, Thomas on the point now, has a lane, but fans it off to DiArdio, but that's another pad stop by Weimer. Now the Cardinals cannot keep that one in, so they will go bring it back into their own zone and reset, as here's DiArdio trying to get that one up to Lanny, but some stout Brockport defense here. And so Schiller now leaving that one off for Bulger. Bulger now getting that one ahead to Jurasek. Jurasek playing that around. Here is Hogg. Hogg over to Bulger. Bulger down to DiArdio. And now here's Hogg. Down to Jurasek. And Jurasek, and that puck goes through the crease of Weimer. Bulger now. 45 seconds left on the Cardinals power play. Jurasek back to Bulger. Bulger shot out in front. Here's Stockdale, but that puck is taken off his stick. And now it's back to Bulger. 36 seconds left in the power play. Here is Hogg. Hogg trying to center that one in front for Stockdale, but Stockdale tangled up there. And so now Katrin will have to bring this one himself. Katrin, 20 seconds left on this Cardinals power play. Katrin will skate around and dump it for Weaver Vitale, who puts it over to Breyer. Now to Jurasek, back to Breyer, and now out in front of Katrin, and a great chance there, but Weimer shoves that one aside. And so now, 3 seconds left on this power play, and Brockport with a great defensive showing there on the penalty kill. They gotta be happy about that one. Dickinson has to be patting his players on the back.
Oh, power play opportunity for the Cardinals, and the Cardinals miss opportunity. They go 0 for 1 for power plays tonight.
So now Weaver Vitale fights with Roach for that one, and Roach gets it out to Bro. Bro now for the Eagles. The puck taking off his stick, a good hit there by Breyer. Now Weaver Vitale, the puck in the legs of the referee, and Roach is fighting for it for the Eagles. Now there's Belgrave getting it out. Breyer trying to make something happen as Tredowitz has to play that one in, but that one is called offsides.
Oh, so close on the opportunity right there. You know, trying to keep that puck within the Brockport zone. Of course, Brockport's defense, they're really showing it. The Cardinals, offensively, they have not been able to do something at all.
And so at this point, you still have to stay cool-headed, but definitely it's starting to get a little annoying that that puck hasn't found the back of the net. And so now here comes Jagger Benson. Unable, though, to get that past the Brockport blue line. And so Rodrigue will have to dump that one in and around and find Sarbaugh. And so Butler gets it out for Plattsburgh, bringing it into the neutral zone and moving it up. Sutherland trying to get there, but that's some good defense by Rodrigue as Butler will come in to help. So now on the near boards, there's a fight for it. But Butler comes out successful. But he runs into two more Golden Eagles. As Benson now, Ring gets it on his stick, and great effort to keep it in as he plays it to Butler. Butler now down to Benson. Benson, his shot is blocked in front by Rodrigue, and Benson's second shot is gloved down by Weimer.
You can really see the frustration coming from this Cardinal offense, and they're getting the opportunities. They're ahead in shots on goal, 12-5, and it's amazing that the Golden Eagles are up by one with only 5 shots on goal.
And it's still early, but these Cardinals cannot let this frustration get to them, because that can only build, because there is still a long way to go. 4:19 left in this first period, and that's another glove stop by Weimer.
Well, you can really see why Weimer has started all, well, 3 for 3. He's really started at the goaltending position, and with 78 saves before this game, it's really showing why he's the starting goalie.
And he's a perfect 13 for 13 through through 16 minutes here in this one, Eli. And so now it's Breyer and Belgrave trying to fight for that one, but unable to come away with it. And so Tredowitz will play that in his own zone. Breyer back to Tredowitz. And so these Cardinals now will look to get some offense going here as Breyer will bring it in. But Belgrave offsides there, and so it'll be brought back into the neutral zone.
Well, you know, the speed gets to you, and when you're really frustrated on trying to score a goal, it gets to you, and you don't even see when your other player is right next to you.
Speed kills, but speed in this sport has to be smart. As Bulger now will play that over to Bellina, and Bellina will bring it into the offensive zone. Thomas now trying to get that one around to Lanny, but the Cardinals are unsuccessful again, and the Golden Eagles come away with that. So Sanchez now looking to make something happen, but he's met with by Bellina. Lanny able to get that one over to Stockdale, and a nice pass over there to Bulger, who will take it in, looking for Lanny, but that's some great defense there by Dominic Chirico. And so now Sanchez will move that back out for the Golden Eagles. Here comes Rosebaum on the puck, and Harley will dump that one in. So Stockdale up to Thomas. Thomas bringing this one in, but no one is there for help as Plattsburgh looks to change. And so now Maxwell will bring it in for Brockport. Harley now getting that one, but Maxwell unable to get that one down with his glove. So it's played behind Schiller. And Katrin comes up with that one on the far boards. Ring to Jurasek. Jurasek now to play it in himself. Jurasek trying to center that one for Katrin, but that just hits the leg of Bro as Ramakers brings that one up and out. Ramakers trying the wraparound, but Schiller's pad is there to meet the puck. And that puck hit off the face mask of Hogg. Great stop there from him. Now Bargallo, his shot blocked in front by Jurasek. Diardio getting that one out for the Cardinals. Roach now playing that for Brockport. And so the Cardinals now making a full change as Barbagallo brings that one into the Cardinals' defensive zone.
This puck has been really been kept in this Cardinals' zone.
So now here comes Butler. He's got Sutherland to his far side, and he's brought down there by Bro. That was Gates over there. And so Harley now to bring it in. Sutherland on the puck for the Cardinals. But Rosenbaum takes that one right away. Ring. And so 1 minute left here at the Ronald B. Stafford in this first period. Cardinals still down 1-0, even though they have a 9-shot on goal advantage. Brockport's offense has been up to the challenge this afternoon.
It's just been really a Brockport game in this first period. The Cardinals just haven't been able to keep this puck on their side.
And so 30 seconds left. Here's Butler. His shot gloved. Great stop by Dylan Weimer.
Well, this offense has to get by Weimer. And it's painful to say, but Brockport has been on top of their stuff tonight. And this offense has been cold.
Yeah, and the Cardinals, maybe a little bit of that celebration hangover from last night carrying over in this first period. We'll see if maybe things can change in the second as Ring shot doesn't get through the first player. And it will be Sanchez who trips up Breyer on that one. And so 21 seconds left in this first period. The Cardinals will go back on the power play.
Whoa, there you go. You know, the defense overcomes and Brockport takes the penalty there, And now the Cardinals only have 21.2 seconds to really tie up this game.
And maybe this is just what the doctor ordered for the Cardinals. Maybe get some momentum here heading into the locker room. So, starting off this power play, Weaver Vitale gets it over to Hogg. Hogg down to Breyer, back to Hogg, over to Weaver Vitale. Weaver Vitale, a goal on the season. Here's Hogg, his shot out in front, tipped by Breyer, and Weaver Vitale unable to keep that one in the zone as this period comes to a close. The score here, the SUNY Brockport Golden Eagles 1, your Plattsburgh Cardinals 0. Shots on goal, 15-7 in advantage for the Cardinals, though they're down 1-0. Eli, what'd you see here in that first period?
Well, for the Cardinals side, it's been an offense struggle for them, and I don't know what happened last night that has caused them to really struggle tonight. It's still early in the game to really say, but the Cardinals have to come out offensively hot and coming into the second period.
And so for the Golden Eagles, it was Scott Ramakers to get that opening goal. You know, it looked like Schiller had that save, but it just bounces through, trickles into the net past the goal line, and so they get an early 1-0 lead. So these Cardinals playing this game seemingly on the defensive end a lot here early in this one. You know they don't like to be down there. You know they like to be on the offensive side. How do they get more offense going in that second period?
Well, they just have to take advantage of the power play opportunities. Plus, they have to get around Weimer. Weimer has been on, you know, he has been on track today, and it's really just adding on to his stats. Remember, he has 78 saves in this season, and he's just adding on to why he's the starting goalie for Brockport.
Yeah, Dylan Weimer here through this first period of perfect 15 for 15. Head coach Brian Dickinson has to be happy with his netminder there. But on the other side for the Cardinals, Eli Schiller, yes, he let that one go through, but 6 for 7 there in that first period. Solid period there from Eli.
No, it's been a solid period for him. But giving up that one goal, you know, he had to reset his mindset. He has to be more aggressive now coming into the second period. Overall, his offense has to get back on track. Defensively, the Cardinals have been showing it. They've been aggressive, but offensively, they struggle.
And so now on the Brockport side of things, if you're head coach Brian Dickinson, you got to tell these guys in this locker room, keep doing what you're doing. Keep up this offensive pressure and keep these pucks out of the net if you are Weimer. So what do you do if you are Brockport going into this second?
Whoa, you have to stay with this mindset. Hey, this is the number 3 ranked hockey team in the D3 nation. Overall, we have to be more aggressive offensively and defensively, and we have to continue giving our goalie the defensive, you know, pressure and help that he needs.
So Brockport going into this second period, gotta stay tough, gotta stay strong. And if you are the Cardinals, you have to look to reset coming into the second period. Still a minute 39 left on that power play, and you have to take advantage. If I'm Coach Steve Moffitt, I'm telling my guys, come out strong, come out fast, and come out firing. So we will see you for the start of the second period coming up right after this. Don't go anywhere, folks. Stay right with us here on PSTV. being recorded?
Money line.
mind is talk to
right there.
Into the Ronald B. Stafford Ice Arena here in Plattsburgh, New York, where this second period between your Plattsburgh Cardinals and the SUNY Brockport Golden Eagles is about to get right underway. That first period, though, exciting action. 1-0 lead here for the Golden Eagles coming off that shot from Ramakers that just skipped through Schiller. What are you looking for, Eli, here in this second from Schiller?
Well, if it's from Eli, you know you ought to just step up your game and really just start protecting that goal. Overall, he only gave up one goal, but six saves for just the first period. It's something that he wants to continue on going into the second period, and it's something that he wants to just have as a main focus going into the rest of this game.
And so Plattsburgh, looking to shift this momentum, have the chance to do just that, as they will start this second period here with a power play, a minute 39 left on it. They got 21 seconds, didn't really do much ending that first. Looking to do something here, though, in the second period with that minute 39, plenty of time to get some offensive going. What do they have to do to get it and get that goal in to tie this one back at one?
Well, you just have to take advantage of this 5-on-4 power play right now and really just take advantage that Brockport is a man down, and it should be easier to rebound that puck and get that puck into the goal.
And I think also what would help is figuring out the wall that's in net. His name is Dylan Weimer. Perfect 15 for 15 in that first period. But that's enough of looking at our faces. Time to get back down to the ice as this second period's about to get right underway.
Let's get it.
And so for the Cardinals, it will be Jurasek. And for the Golden Eagles of Brockport, it is Meredith. But it'll be Jurasek who wins that to open this second period with the Cardinals on the power play. So here comes Katrin to move this puck around. Doesn't like what he sees there, decides to turn around with it. Does it not once, but twice.
Oh, as the goal switches around, let's see if the Cardinals can really break out here.
And so here comes Katrin, goal side, and that's another pad stop by Weimer out in front. So getting things started early here, Weimer looks to be unfazed, as there's a minute 11 left in this Cardinals power play.
Andrew Hartley is really the most aggressive player that you can see from the Brockport side, and he's out there protecting his players, and I can see it.
Yeah, not only protecting his players, but protecting his hometown, the native Brockport kid. But here's Katrin now on the puck for the Cardinals. Over to Weaver Vitale, up to Hogg, and back down to Breyer. Breyer now over to Jurasek. Jurasek gets it back down to Breyer in the Gretzky zone. Now Jurasek, his shot goes off the side of the netting. And that puck skips past Weaver Vitale, and the Cardinals will have to reset.
A perfect opportunity to take right there to try to tie this game, and really lost right there. Brockport still showing their defensive moves.
And so here comes Jurasek. Jurasek's shot, and that one almost rings in, but it rings off the post instead. And so here's Hogg at the point, getting it down to Breyer, who's on the outside of that red circle. Now here's Jurasek, his shot again, and that's another stop from Weimer. Man, Jurasek on that one, just going off the corner of the post. Weimer's going to be rubbing that one down, thinking that's a goalie's best friend right there.
No, in fact, he's just been just dominating at the goal, still staying perfect right now, not have allowing a goal at all.
So 25 seconds left here on the Cardinals power play. Stockdale unable to win that one as Bro will hit it around but not past the stick of Bulger. Bulger now 15 seconds left on this Plattsburgh power play. Lanny over to Ring. Ring looking to shoot but decides otherwise. Bulger, he will shoot, and that's deflected by Lanny, but not enough on that one. So now the power play will come to a close. Two shots on that one, as here's the shot from Daddario, but it's another cover up from Weimer.
Weimer really just continuing the dominance at the goal post, and it's just every shot that the Cardinals think is gonna go in, it's just stopped by just that Weimer wall.
Weimer takes, he gives you hope, but shuts any chance of it down. And so Ring, great effort to keep that puck in, but Tredowitz unable to play it. And so Thomas will move it in. Here's Tredowitz now. Tredowitz, his shot out in front, and that puck skating around, but it just trickles wide. And so Tredowitz now on that puck. He'll get some help from Thomas to get this one out of that corner. So Bro will come up with it for the Golden Eagles. Trying to get that one out to Sanchez, but that one is just a bit hard off of the blade of his stick. And so here comes Butler now through the neutral zone. Butler now, that was a great center, but Belgrave not home in time.
Nobody there to rebound.
No, and so now Ramaker's hit up against the boards by Brandon Butler. So Thomas able to take that one away from the centering pass, and Benson will play it behind the net of Eli Schiller. Benson, though, taking off the puck, as here's a chance for Tilly. But Thomas comes away with that for Plattsburgh.
No, you missed it.
But Chirico, his shot out in front, and Eli Schiller, some great stops there out in front to keep this at a 1-0 game.
When he is, it's just been a goalie-to-goalie battle right now. Eli, he's also showing off his moves. You missed it, huh? He literally left an empty net and still came back to block that puck. That is crazy. This is amazing. This is an amazing performance from both sides, and it's showing why both goalies are, you know, they're starters and they're top contenders for the top goalie spot in this UNIAC.
You got that right. So it'll be Galloway against Thomas here for this faceoff off to the glove side of Schiller, and Galloway wins that for the Golden Eagles. But Harley can't get to that one. And it'll be Belgrave to get that one out, but not before Rosenbaum sends that one back into the Cardinals zone. Butler now getting that one over to Ring. But that puck taken off the stick of Ring. And Butler will have to play that one out into the neutral zone. And now here's Benson with a great stick work there to poke that one away. But the ref will stop play, and we will have a face-off down in the Brockport zone. So now the puck near Brockport ice. Jurasek wins that one for the Cardinals, and Bulger will play it over to Singer. Singer now moving that one into the offensive zone. And it's Gates who takes it away and up to Meredith. But Bulger, great defensive stick work there to take that stick off of the blade of Meredith. But now Serafin trying to move that one in and around, but is unsuccessful. And that shot from the point is wide from Barbagallo. Here's Katrin now. He's got help. Daddario off to his side. Daddario now on the puck, and Jurasek out in front, but a great stop by Weimer to get those pillows down in time. Now here's Singer playing the puck for the Cardinals. 15:25 left in this second period. Bulger now out. His shot is right into the logo of Weimer.
Right on target, but still nothing from the Cardinals offense, as it's just been just a goalie showcase right now.
Yes, definitely Dylan Weimer putting on a clinic out here in the Ronald B.
Feels like another Jacob Hearn situation from last night.
So now Weaver Tally gets that puck over to Hogg, and Hogg will just have to dump that one down to Lanny, who's behind the net. And so Lanny losing his edge there, but keeping control of the puck. Have to move it down for Thomas, and Thomas gets it back to Hogg. Hogg now playing it, looking for Stockdale, but he decides to center that one, but no one's out in front. Stockdale now on the puck. Back to Hogg. Hogg out for Lanny in front and scores! Jake Lanny ties this one up for the Cardinals, and it's all even here in Plattsburgh.
The perfect save opportunity streak is over as Weimer finally lets a goal pass him. The Cardinals tied the game with only 14 minutes and 51 seconds left in this second period.
And wow. So 14:51 left, and it's a brand new hockey game here at the Ronald B. Stafford Ice Arena in Plattsburgh, New York.
It's just the mindset of 0-0.
And so now Bellina plays that one, trying to get it to Belgrave, but it's just a bit too hard. So he's Chernowitz centering for Belgrave out in front, and that's a great stop by Weimer, and it looks like momentum has shifted in the favor of the Cardinals.
The table has turned as Brockport's momentum offensively has now went back to the Cardinals side.
And if you are head coach Steve Moffitt, you have to be happy with how your players are playing so far in this second period. You needed to swing momentum, and it looks like you have done just that, as Bulger will put that one in on net, but it's wide of the pad side of Weimer. So now Belgrave fighting for that one down puck side, but it is Brockport to come away with that one. Chirico getting that one down, and Schiller will have to cover up as there's pressure from Ramekers. So faceoff now coming to the glove side of Schiller. It'll be Galloway versus Jurasek here, and Galloway takes that one for the Golden Eagles. Here's Harley. Harley trying to shoot that one in on net, but that one is just on the outside. So here comes Daddario. Daddario with Bulger, but Katrin has a chance, but that one just skips off the blade of his stick. And so now here's a chance for Harley out all by himself. But that's a hit out in front. A good stop there by this Plattsburgh defense. As here's Harley, his shot blocked in front out by Daddario. And the shot out from the point is high and wide. That's Gates on that one.
Full pressure now lost from Brockport, and there's a delayed penalty.
And so heading to the box is the captain for these Golden Eagles, Connor Galloway, out of Sugar Hill, Georgia.
The senior out of Sugar Hill, Georgia. Wow. I may have to take a trip over there. I've never been to Georgia before.
Thought there's supposed to be some southern hospitality. What happened there? And so now the Cardinals will go back on the power play, see if they can take advantage here.
Well, for one tonight on power play opportunities, can they end the streak?
And so here's Thomas out on the point, leaves that one for Daddario. Daddario, his shot blocked down in front by Ramekers. Stockdale now. And the crowd trying to get into this one, letting their players hear their support. And that shot by Bulger is blocked out in front. Great defensive awareness there from Meredith as Brockport will make a change. So here's Bulger up to Thomas. 1:15 left on this Cardinals power play. Daddario trying to play in on Rosebaum. Runs into Stockdale there. Daddario trying to push that one in on the near side post, but he is met by the pad of Weimer.
A good save right there. Just really trying to break this offensive momentum that the Cardinals have.
Yeah, great puck tracking there from the netminder of Brockport. Now here's Weaver Vitale over to Hogg. A minute left in this power play. Breyer has the puck now. Back to the point man, it's Weaver. Weaver, no look pass to Breyer, but Brockport all over that one as Hogg has to reset. Breyer now up to Weaver Vitale. Vitale back to Hogg. Hogg over to Breyer, his shot's covered up in between the pads of Weimer. 12:17 left here in this second. 45 seconds left on the Plattsburgh power play.
Cardinals trying to really take this opportunity. If Brockport can save another chance, they can really end this power play without giving up a goal.
And so Jurasek winning that faceoff, and the shot from Hogg is blocked out in front by Meredith. And now a fight for it, but the puck is in the netting.
Just on the opposite side, not in there.
So Jurasek wins another one for the Cardinals. And Hogg gets that down to Breyer. Breyer now near side, and that one skips through the crease, but no one in front. And now Hogg over to Jurasek for the one-timer, and it's a great awareness stop by Weimer.
Weimer is showcasing a lot right now. I thought that puck was going to go in.
Yeah, great one-timer opportunity by Jurasek, but Weimer able to move across his crease and catch up to that one and make a great glove stop.
The great wall of Weimer right now for the Brockport side.
And so Jurasek, another great faceoff win, gets it to Weaver Vitale. 17 seconds left on this Plattsburgh power play.
Broken
and that
stick.
One hits a broken stick as Katrin was looking for the one-timer there. As here's Katrin up to Weaver Vitale for the one-timer. And that one tried to be batted down in front by Breyer, but unable to connect. As this power play comes to a close, Hogg will slap that one out in front, but Katrin unable to deflect that one as it trickles wide. So now Breyer trying to center that one, but Katrin again unable to come away with that, as Jurasek will play that one down. Here's Breyer. Breyer now comes up off the puck, and here's Galloway to take that in fresh out of the box with help from Gates. Gates now, his shot hits the side netting, and Weaver Vitale comes away with that one. Weaver Vitale playing some great defense, but Brockport able to come away with that one, but that shot high and wide by Flansburgh. Flansburgh, though, able to regroup with that puck, and that centered out in front, and that shot by Rodrigue is patted away by Schiller. And so now here comes Belgrave with Tredowitz for help. Belgrave now playing in against Bro, and Bro able to win that defensive battle now. Here's Flansburgh over to Sanchez. Sanchez back over to the captain, Galloway over to Rodrigue. His shot blocked down in front by Thomas. Bro now. Bro's shot trickles through and able to come away with that, as here's Thomas with a one-time opportunity, a one-on-one chance, but that pass just a little too hard as it skips off the front blade edge of his stick. As now here comes Harley for the Eagles as he gets it over to Galloway. Galloway to Rodrigue, and that pass a little too hard as it bumps off of his skate. Now here comes Jagger Benson. Jagger Benson now moving that one through, but Maxwell takes that one away from him. So, 9:55 left, halfway through this one, as Jagger Benson moves it into the offensive zone to Butler, but Butler unable to get a shot away. Great defense here from the Golden Eagles, led by Maxwell. And now Bro fighting with the Cardinals offensive player. That'll be Riley Sutherland. And so Sutherland fighting for it, but unable to come away with it, as that'll go across the ice for Singer. But Singer, his only option is to get it to Jurasek. Jurasek now brings it in himself. He dekes one, gets the opportunity, but that's another great stop by Weimer out in front. And so now this puck moves all the way back down into the Cardinals' defensive zone. Here is Jack Ring. Jack Ring now looking to make something happen, but that puck taken off his stick by Rosenbaum. Bellina dumping that one in. It's his only option. Gets it over to Lanny. Daddario. Dario looking to get net side on that one. We'll move it to Bulger, and Bulger, his shot just wide of the stick of Weimer. And that shot from Bellina, easily taken out of the air by the glove of Weimer.
It's been a back and forward this period, and right there, it's just been a full dominant performance from the Cardinals offensively. And you can't say anything else about it, really. It's they came out the gate on fire, both offensively and defensively.
They've done what they've needed to do so far to get back into this one, Eli, but they just can't get ahead because of one man, Dylan Weimer.
Oh, you can't say anything else. He's just been on his A game tonight, and it's just something that the Golden Eagles are really proud of.
Yep, they have to be proud of him, especially Coach Brian Dickinson. So now Stockdale, his stick breaks in half, unable to control that puck. And so Belgrave will try to move that one past the blue line. Unsuccessful, though, as Thomas will have to do it himself.
Second stick broken this game, and it's just been really power overpowering everything.
And so that's Roach bringing it in with Rosenbaum, and Rosenbaum's shot is just high of the stick, or excuse me, the glove of Schiller. And so now a fight for here on the near boards, but Gates will play that one himself. So that puck taken away by Hogg and played up to Belgrave. Here's Barbagallo. That one just too hard for him, and Gates will have to play it for himself. So we have Vitali coming up with that one. He gets it over to Breyer. Breyer now trying to center it for Belgrave, trying to center it for Tredowitz, trying to get on that one, but he is unable to as he was tangled up in front by a Brockport defender.
Opportunity miss right there for the Cardinals.
But here comes Butler. He's got Tredowitz, but it's a great stop by Barbagallo.
Brockport is still showing that defensive power right now in this second period.
Still being strong defensively, even though Plattsburgh has gained offensive momentum. But here comes the Golden Eagles. It's Flansburgh and Sanchez. Here's Sanchez up to Rodrigue. Rodrigue, his shot blocked in front by Weaver Vitale. And so now it is Sutherland on the puck. Sutherland, his shot just high of the glove of Weimer. Now Sanchez plays that puck out. Sanchez on it. Sanchez bringing it himself. He's got Flansburgh looking for him but cannot connect. Now Rodrigue up to Flansburgh, over to Sanchez. The two Flansburgh brothers here on the same line. Here's a shot from Rodrigue, and it almost goes in, but it hits off the post. Goalie's best friend there. Eli is going to be thanking that beautiful orange bar later.
This was an eye for an eye for both teams now, as both teams have experienced a close one right there.
You've got that right. Now here's Flansburgh, who moves it in for Brockport, but no Golden Eagles there. The only people there are Cardinals. Now Katrin getting it over to Daddario. But Harley takes that one away. Harley now up to Maxwell. Maxwell looking for Galloway, but Katrin in front to take that one away for Plattsburgh. And now moving up ice is Ring. But great defensive stop there from Rosenbaum as Maxwell looks to move that one back in. Maxwell, though, met by Brennan Butler. And that puck has to come back up and out. So now here's Daddario on it in the defensive zone for the Cardinals. He's got Katrin to his side. Daddario moving through, but Weimer covers that up for a faceoff.
Cardinals really trying to pressure this zone. And Brockport, they're just still doing their things. And defensively, they haven't really broken down or anything.
It looked like at one point that the Cardinals were breaking them down, but it seems like that has slowed up and it has gone back to a defensive battle. But here's Bulger now to Stockdale. Stockdale looking for Thomas out in front, But Stockdale tied up there, and it's some great defense by Gates. And so Bulger over to Singer. Singer, his shot out in the front is blocked. So Bulger will have to reset, getting it up to Thomas. Thomas now looking for Stockdale, but Gates gets there first. Stockdale now getting it to Thomas. Thomas back to Stockdale, but that pass too hard, and Gates comes away with it for the Golden Eagles. Ooh. And that's a tough hit there from Lanny as Gates is down on the ice. And so now Jake Lanny will be headed to the box off of that hard hit on Gates for Brockport. And so the ref's discussing here how long this penalty should be.
Well, it wasn't really intentional. Overall, things happen. The speed of the game gets to you. So if it does take, you know, if it's more than 2 minutes right here, it has to be at least for roughing or charging. It's not say charging at least.
So we'll see here as the refs have concluded their discussions, skating over to that Brockport ice. Skating over to the Plattsburgh bench now. Informing the coaches of the penalty. And so they will send off Jake Lanny. He will be out of the game.
An ejection that it was hard to really decide for the refs. And of course, you know, they have to protect the safety of all these players out here. So it's understandable why this call was made.
And so Lanny will head to that locker room early. He's not going to be happy about that.
Oh, of course, and you know, it can cost you a game, but seeing how the Cardinals have played, let's see if they can continue the momentum.
And so that hard shot off the point from Gates, Schiller makes a great save now. And so the Brockport Golden Eagles, after that major penalty, will go on a 5-minute power play. So here's Gates, who took the brunt of that hit. Gets it over to Galloway, and now Galloway will play it himself, but he is met there by Hogg. Maxwell comes away with it and is able to get that puck up and out. Now here's Rodrigue. And now great defensive play by Jurasek, but just unable to track the puck there. Hogg unable to clear it. Jurasek also unable to clear it, as it's a great stop on the blue line to keep it in by Harley. Here's Maxwell. And it's a great defensive clear by the Plattsburgh Cardinals. So Rodrigue has to play this one and reset behind his own net. 3:42 left in this power play, 2:52 left in the period. Ramekers up to Rodrigue. Rodrigue looking to pass, but decides not to. Here's Barbagallo back down to Ramekers. Ramekers trying to get that one near side, and that puck out in front, and Schiller makes a stop, but there's an open net, and Schiller another stop with the pads.
Schiller not allowing nothing to get past them, as this power play already at 3 minutes, and Brockport can't really figure something out.
But here comes Ramekers. Ramekers threw in on net, and here's the shot from Sanchez, and that is another great stop from Schiller. Here's Rodrigue. Rodrigue, and that's some great defense there by Tredowitz to reset this Brockport power play. 2:44 left on it. Here's Barbagallo up to Harley. Harley over to Rodrigue. Rodrigue up to Maxwell. Maxwell got Flansburgh off to his flank and Harley back behind him, but he is pinned there by Bulger. And Bellina will play this one behind Schiller and kill another couple crucial seconds off of this major power play. So now it's Gates. Gates bringing this one down and in for Brockport. And that's a nice defensive stop there by Jurasek. Weimer playing it up to Galloway. So a minute 54 left on this power play. Harley now. Harley centering out in front.
Ooh.
And that's another big hit. And the net comes off its bearings, so we will have a stoppage in play. And so even though Lanny going off earlier for that big hit, the Cardinals still not scared to throw a good shoulder in.
No, it's really, it's a one-to-one game. You're reaching the final seconds of the second period, and it's going to get aggressive. And you seeing it from both sides, it's going to get, it's going to become an aggressive game.
So 59 seconds here left in this second frame. Still a 1-1 game. Brockport, though, a minute 47 left on their power play. The major from Jake Lanny. But Flansburgh wins that one for Brockport as it's hit out to Rodrigue. And Sanchez back to Rodrigue. Rodrigue, his shot in front, blocked by Butler. But Sanchez back on the punt. Here's Barbagallo, his shot out in front. That rebound unable to be eaten up by Ramekers. But now here's Rodrigue over to Sanchez. Sanchez now a minute 30 left on this power play. Rodrigue down to Barbagallo. Back to Rodrigue. Rodrigue, his shot out in front, blocked by Jurasek. And Butler able to clear that one.
Plattsburgh going for some changes on the line, and it's just really regrouping and trying to continue to waste this power play advantage for Brockport.
Yep, a minute 9 left on the power play, but 19 seconds left in this second as Rodrigue just has to send that one down, and Flansburgh will meet that one. But it's too hard as Tretowitz will move that away, and now a 2-on-1 opportunity. Tretowitz with Belgrave and Hogg, and that one too hard for Hogg as there's 3 seconds left, the dying seconds, and Tretowitz! That's another great stop by Weimer to end this second period as it ends in a tie, 1-1 here. But Plattsburgh able to get that goal back as they started this period down 1 goal. What do you like in so far here? What did you like in that second, Eli?
Well, offensively, the Cardinals did pop off. They did their things to tie the game. Of course, they did lose a player, and it was just mostly, it was accidental. But for the refs, they have to protect older players. The NCAA also protecting older players. They can't let a player go down from an injury like that. That charging becomes an ejection. And it cost the Cardinals a player, which now they have to take this power play opportunity to the third period with a 5-on-4 advantage.
So now that's 2 back-to-back games with 5-minute major penalties. And how do you fix that if you're head coach Steve Moffitt? What do you tell your guys in the locker room? Because you have to stay aggressive, but obviously you're being too aggressive.
Well, it's really the speed overcomes. Be smart with your speed. Remember, we need the open puck opportunity, open goal opportunity. Try to get that puck on the goal, rebound. Keep your mind on trying to win this game.
Yep, and so the big story of that second period, the Cardinals able to get that goal back, and it was a beauty right off the side of the net. What did you like from the Cardinals' offense off that goal?
Whoa. Overall, they came into the second period saying we need to tie this game up and we want to continue this undefeated season. And the Cardinals did just that. And that second goal, well, that first, you know, the game goal, the tie of the game, my fault. It allowed them to bring a momentum to their offensive side and end the drought offensively that they have had in the first period.
Yeah, and then the big story here, these two netminders, Weimer and Schiller. Weimer, 30 for 31. Schiller, 16 for 17. You've had to like both of these goalies so far. I think Weimer has the edge, though. Would you agree?
Well, of course. Weimer has been just getting more opportunities, and he has been really stopped this offense from scoring. Overall, the offense just has to find a way to try to get that puck, rebound it, or get an open net opportunity. And it's just been like that for both sides. So I can really see why Weimer's just been the top, you know, he's just been the spotlight player right now just because of the opportunities he's been getting.
Yeah, so heading into this third period, is a brand new hockey game. You basically erase the deficit. It is, even though it's 1-1, it's almost like it's 0-0. Steve Moffitt, Brian Dickinson, what do these two coaches have to tell Brockport and the Cardinals respectively?
Well, you just have to keep on having that 0-0 mentality. Just think of, you know, you need to score that game winner coming into this third period. For Brockport, they want to get over 500. For the Cardinals, they want to keep this undefeated season alive, and they also want to get that first place spot, which they can with a win right here.
Well, we'll see if they can keep that spot. We'll see if the Cardinals can stay undefeated or if the Brockport Golden Eagles will come up with the fantastic upset here. Third period action coming your way right after this one. Don't go anywhere, folks. This game is just getting started. To the Ronald B. Stafford Ice Arena here in Plattsburgh, New York, where it is a tie game here, all tied up between the Plattsburgh Cardinals and the Brockport Golden Eagles. So getting confirmation from the refs there that that Jake Lanny penalty, direct contact to the head, they call that one. How do you feel about that, Eli?
Well, like I said before, this is just the refs acting on protecting their players. And, of course, it was a call that was really just accidental. And hopefully, you know, from Brockport's side, that player is doing well. As for the Cardinals, Lanny gets ejected from the game, even though he did also provide Brockport with a five-minute power play, which can Brockport still take advantage of that power play?
Yeah, so it was Jacob Gates taking the brunt of that hit. He was able to get up, looked fine. But Jake Lanny, he was the one who was able to get the goal for these Cardinals. And now that the goal scorer is out, to be able to come back, you have to be able to show resilience and you gotta show your toughness out here in this one. We'll see if the Cardinals can do that here. But as you were saying, Brockport starting this third, 48 seconds left on that five-minute power play. They have to take advantage here if they want to win this game. But we are just about to get started here. This third period action about to get right underway. Let's get you back down to that ice so you don't miss a second of it. So coming out to start this third period, it'll be Galloway versus Tredowitz, the two captains, and Galloway wins it for Brockport. So 44 seconds left on this Brockport power play. We'll see if they can get anything done here to start this third period. So Galloway will play it, but he'll decide not to and pass it back to Gates. But here's a takeaway. And Belgrave loses his edge there in the circle. And that was a prime opportunity as he had Tredowitz off to his side for a one-timer.
Get ready for the aggressiveness coming out of the gates. And both teams are going to show it as it's still tied 1-1.
And so now Maxwell plays it around Schiller. Here's Harley. Harley trying to make something happen, but a great defensive stand by Bulger. And so this power play will come to an end. Great defensive showing on the penalty kill for the full 5 minutes from the Cardinals.
The Cardinals really showing that even with a man down, they can still do it defensively.
And Weaver Vitale there knocking Flansburgh off the puck. Got to give a big shout out to Kevin Weaver Vitale. Has played some great defense here in this one.
Oh, he has, and he's been showing it too why he's the starting goalie for this team.
Yes, part of that top pairing, him and Ryan Hogg. Gotta start the game, started out right with a stellar top D pairing. So there's contact there with the goalie. There's with Weimer and Daddario, but that shot from Jurasek is covered up. Weimer able to recover in time.
Well, the goalie always gotta protect himself as well. And it gets to that point where, hey, if you get in the goalie's way, he can do whatever he wants to really get that goal path safe and from use from scoring.
Exactly. That crease is the goalie's territory. They will hit you. They will berate you if you even think about getting anywhere close to that. So here's Ring now, and that shot just trickles off the deflection of Stockdale.
It's been a back and forth on the faceoff. Of course, the Cardinal lead by two in faceoff one.
And so Stockdale wins that one for Plattsburgh, and it'll be Ring to get it down to Butler. But not before Rodriguez decides to take that one away. But Stockdale, great hustle there to get that one back out to Thomas. As now here's Singer with the shot, and out front, Weimer makes the stop, and Stockdale cannot connect with that rebound.
Oh, the referee gets in the way as well.
So here's Chirico getting that one out. But Thomas sends it back in, and Chirico sends it back out. So a big hit here near the box. And so we will have another penalty here, as it will be Brandon Butler's hit that will send him to the box for two. And so Brockport, just coming off that penalty a few minutes ago, will go back on the power play. And not the start you wanted here if you're Plattsburgh.
It really isn't the start right now, but things happen. It's a part of a game.
And so Brockport wins that faceoff, but Belgrave able to get it out.
This is Brandon Butler's second penalty taken this year.
So Brockport here, resetting, setting up, see if they can get something here going to start this power play. A minute 30 left in it. Here's Sanchez, that shot is whiffed on, and Tredowitz able to hit that one down as Plattsburgh will make a full line change. Here comes Rodrigue on the puck for the Golden Eagles. Rodrigue leaves it for Flansburg, but Butler is there. Flansburg fighting with Hogg, and Hogg is able to get it around out to Butler, who gets it to Weaver Vitale, who dumps it into the Brockport zone to kill another couple seconds off this power play and allow the Cardinals to make another change. 46 seconds left here on the power play.
You need to get some line changes. You need to regroup. Brockport taking advantage, trying to get their players back on the defensive side. Oh!
And there's a hard mid-ice collision, and they are still entangled, but here's a chance for Tredowitz, and Tredowitz unable to connect on that chance, and so now a penalty coming to Brockport on that hit.
Whoa, what can you say? It's just, you know, when the contact happens, it happens, and when you can't press the brakes, it's over. You know, you got to take that penalty right there.
Galloway just ran right into Belgrave. Belgrave had nowhere to go there. And so we will have 4-on-4 action, some open ice for 28 seconds, and then the Cardinals will go on the 5-on-4 advantage for a minute 30. So it's Tredowitz and Maxwell, and Maxwell wins that one for Brockport. Maxwell, back to Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum circling around, doesn't like what he sees, so he'll hand it off to Chirico. Chirico, though, will give it right back to Belgrave. Belgrave trying to get some 4-on-4 offense going here for Plattsburgh, but had that puck taken away. And so now here's Maxwell and Rosenbaum, and Rosenbaum's shot is wide of the stick of Schiller.
Plattsburgh got full force.
So now we've got another penalty coming to Brockport, as that will be a cross check here headed to Andrew Harley. And so after the 4-on-4 expired, we will have a minute 26 of 5-on-3 play for Plattsburgh.
Galloway and Harley taking their first penalty of the year, and it hurts, but this is a chance for the Cardinals to take advantage now that it's a 5-on-3 advantage for the Cardinals.
And this is the best chance they've had all night at taking this lead. So we'll see if Plattsburgh on this 5-on-3 man advantage can do something, as it's out to the point for a ring. Over to Bolger now. Bolger looking for Stockdale. Stockdale is shot and it's gloved. Right snagged by Weimer.
Oh, the perfect opportunity to score right now, seeing that Brockport is only 3 men on the ice and nothing really there from the Cardinals side.
So we'll have Thomas, who wins the faceoff for the Cardinals. Stockdale over to Ring. Ring now. Ring with the shot, and that's blocked in front by Ramakers, who clears it away. So Schiller now will have to play that himself up to Bennett Stockdale. Here comes Stockdale through offensive zone. Stockdale back around the net. Leaves it for Bolger. Bolger back over to Ring. Ring taking that point. Here's Bolger. His shot is just high. Ring gets that back. Ring leaving it for Bolger. Bolger now trying to get it over to Daddario, trying to get it outside in the crease, and the ref blows the whistle there. And now they're getting into it in that Brockport goal.
A little bit of a second right there, but of course it gets to you when your goalie is under attack and that puck is just free out there on the ice. So I can see why Brockport got a little bit frustrated right there, but overall, what a good effort from Weimer to keep that puck from not being able to be scored from the Cardinals.
And so Weimer, after that contact, has to fix his mask a bit, and Rosenbaum, after the contact with Weimer from the Cardinals, Rosenbaum letting the refs hear it.
What else can you really say? Like, if you're getting under attack there, would you not defend your goalie at that point? It's like common sense at that point when you're playing hockey.
So Weimer all fixed up. And so the Cardinals, 30 seconds will be left on this 5-on-3 advantage.
Cardinals right now 28-22 with faceoff one.
Yeah, it's been a close battle here with faceoffs, but the Cardinals having that slight edge. And so we'll see if that faceoff success can carry over here, as it seems that Steve Moffitt, head coach for the Plattsburgh Cardinals, is having a little chat here with the referees as he's calling over referee Merriman there. It'll be Jurasek and Ramakers for the faceoff here in the neutral zone. And Jurasek wins it right to the stick of Weaver Vitale. Here's Hogg over to Katrin. Hogg will take that puck here to Weaver Vitale at the point. Back down to Breyer. Over to Weaver Vitale to Breyer. Right, Weaver Vitale, his shot is wide of Weimer. And so now, end of the 5-on-3, but the Cardinals still on the power play here as Weaver Vitale gets that one back. Over to Breyer, back to Hogg. Hogg back to Breyer. Breyer now down and around to Jurasek. Jurasek skating that one into the zone, but that one is blocked by a stick and it goes out of play.
Too high, too wide. Can't get that shot in. It's a fly.
And so, unable to take advantage on the 5-on-3, but still 20 seconds left here on the single-man power play for the Cardinals.
Trying to go for power face-off number 31.
And they'll win it as Daddario hits it back out to Ring, who gets it over to Bolger, and his shot is blocked in front by Rodrigue. Now Rodrigue fighting for it down in the corner with Stockdale and Daddario. Here's Bolger back to Daddario. Daddario over to Ring as this power play expires, and it is back to even strength as Harley exits the box. So no advantage taken there on the power plays for the Cardinals. Here's Bro. And there's another mid-ice collision there. It's Galloway and Thomas.
Galloway going back to his old routine, even coming out of the penalty box.
And so there, Stockdale is able to get it up to Thomas, who's able to find Bulger on the far side. Bulger now trying to get it in front to Daddario, but that one is just tipped out wide by a defender. So the puck moves out in front. It's Galloway. Galloway now skating through mid-ice. Into the offensive zone is Maxwell. And now here is Stockdale to get it out. And here's an opportunity for Tredowitz. Tredowitz, his shot, blocked out in front. Great stop by Weimer. So another opportunity goes to the wayside for Plattsburgh. Here's Brockport with it, trying to control that puck in the neutral zone, but will decide to just send it down and around. It's Singer on it. Singer trying to find Belgrave, but Belgrave is met by Barbagallo. Gates playing it around. He finds Sanchez now with the puck, but Sanchez will move that down, and Schiller will cover up. And, a little bit of a hit after the end of that one, but the refs move it aside.
Oh, but hit right there. You can see that Brockport, they're just trying their best to be as aggressive as they can.
Yeah, so both teams trying whatever they can, it seems like, to shake both goalies.
At this point, it's like if you can't get past the goalie, you just got to shake them up at that point.
Yeah, you got to try and do anything you can, it seems that these teams are doing, to get them out of rhythm so that only one, because that's all they need, is one to trickle through. But Brockport wins this faceoff as it's Chirico who plays it near the blue line. Hogg comes away with it, though, at the end boards. But Sanchez takes that one right back. And here's Chirico, who tried to take that shot off the point, but it just skates off his stick. Now here's Flansburgh fighting with Hogg, and Jurasek able to come away with that one. But it's Sanchez who takes it away, and Chirico plays it to Rosenbaum. Jurasek trying to get that one over to Daddario, but it only gets as far as Weaver Vitale. So now five players fighting for it down there, and Jurasek comes away with it successfully. As there's Hogg. Hogg gets it up to Katrin, and Daddario can only tap it up as Plattsburgh will make a full line change. So now it is Rosenbaum holding it behind the net for Brockport. And he will be the one to start this offensive drive. Rosenbaum trying to leave it, but he loses his stick, and now it's Thomas and Stockdale, and Thomas trying to get it to the stick of Stockdale, but it's a great diving stop in front by Chirico.
A fast break opportunity missed right there for the Cardinals. Brockport is still getting back fast.
And so here's Stockdale now on it with help from Thomas, but Brockport with some stout defense down there, and they are able to come away with it. So now Brockport skates it through neutral ice, but hits it out into the Plattsburgh bench.
Both of these teams are really just, they've been cold coming out into the third period, and it's just been their defense just showing it off lately, and it's an A1 effort from both sides.
And so, 10:36 left in this game, things have to start getting crucial here.
Oh, of course, and especially if you're running away and shots on goal, it has to tell you something. We have to fix something from the Cardinals side.
So Schiller plays that one down and around. And Breyer trying to get that one up to Belgrave, and Belgrave will hit it over to Tredowitz. But Breyer will take that himself. Breyer now behind the net. That one skips off the blade of his stick. And Bulger will have to try and get that one. Here's Belgrave. Belgrave over to Weaver Vitale, and it's shot and scores! That was Spencer Bellina taking the lead for these Cardinals!
You can say it, and you can even repeat it. These Cardinals, they found a way, and it was Bellina the whole way around. Lucky number 6 right there.
Spencer Bellina with that hot, 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 hot wrister from the point near that blue line. That was a hard shot. That was a far shot. And Weimer had no chance on that one. And the Cardinals able to take a 2-1 lead here. 10 minutes left in this third and final period.
Goal number 5 for the season, and it's lucky number 6 for you.
And so now Brockport stuck in their own defensive zone, and the Cardinals will look to pad this lead.
Oh, Valina really saw that goal opportunity, and he took it.
Valina saw the wide open lane that opened up in front of him, and he did not hesitate, and it paid off. But now here's Daddario getting it out to Singer, and Singer's shot blocked out in front, tipped by Katrin, but not able to get in on net.
And fans, please notice at the conclusion of the game, we will announce the three stars of the game sponsored by...
There will be a call down on the ice as the puck will be sent down back to the Brockport zone. It's getting to me, Hans. The game is getting to me.
Stay strong, Eli.
But goal number 5 for Valina, as Spencer Valina really became the life for the third period Cardinals.
He has added life to this what seemed lifeless Cardinals team that was just fighting but couldn't find it. As there's Stockdale, good awareness to just put that one back in on Molina. But here's Stockdale trying to get that one out in front, but unable to as it goes wide of Weimer. Now here's Ring, getting it over to Stockdale. Rodrigue, hitting it up and out, and that will skip through the legs of Hogg.
Rockford with some changes to the line.
So now Stockdale fighting Rosebaum in the corner for that puck. And now Stockdale getting it up to Tredowitz, but Weimer ready for that one.
It's like a little chip from the hook of the stick right there.
So here's Stockdale, Tredowitz out in front. Stockdale, though, hit off the puck by Chirico. So now it's Sanchez who gets it to Rosenbaum, who move it up to Flansburgh. Valina, the goal scorer, putting the Cardinals up in front, gets that puck back and trying to get out a streaking Belgrave, but Rosenbaum able to get his glove up and stop that one. But here comes Joshua Belgrave. Belgrave now, that one just wide. Jurasek able to re-control that puck and trying to get it out in front for Belgrave, and that one just trickles wide of the post of Weimer.
Belgrave was there positioned well, but couldn't get that rebound as they missed it.
So Bulger here, side of the net is Breyer, and he is hit off the puck by Chirico, and Weimer covers up.
It is something here right now in the Brockport zone, and Brockport, they're getting that full pressure right now from the Cardinals, as the Cardinals, they are offensively alive, and with faceoff, they just continue to lead it. So what else can you say from this Cardinals offense?
And Brockport wins that one as it's Galloway on that faceoff.
Please pick up any garbage around the area where you're receiving for the game and place it in the nearest trash can.
And now Harley tries to move it down to Maxwell, but Singer is there for the Cardinals as Katrin brings it in and will pop it up to Weimer.
A little curveball right there, and there's more fussles, and you can see the frustration from that Brockport side, but hey, it's a part of the game. You got 7 minutes and 10 seconds left. You better just put that frustration and try to score a goal right here.
Yeah, this frustration boiling over and some extra hits coming after the whistles. So it is the Cardinals who win that faceoff. Stockdale in the corner. Gates, though, with some good defense and is able to take it away. It is Harley who will get it, try to get it at least to Maxwell, but it is too hard off of his stick. Here's Singer getting it to Stockdale. But Ring has that puck taken off his stick by Galloway.
You can really see this back and forth right now from both sides, and it's just puck control has been the issue from both sides, and it's just really showing how the defense has been this whole game.
So some fresh skates out for these Cardinals as Hogg with a good defensive stop to deny them, as here's Belgrave, and he's got Breyer off to the side, but Belgrave unable to control the puck as that shot from Weaver Vitale is just, and Trinowitz, a great opportunity, but Weimer, a great stop in front, as here's Breyer with another shot, but that is stopped in front by the defenseman of Brockport.
They're 0 for 4 right now. Can they keep the puck in the zone? No, they can't.
And so some more excellent opportunities out on the doorstep of Weimer, but just not able to put that puck in the back of his net. And so Katrin now will dump that into the Brockport zone. Chirico will come away with it. But that's Dodario to keep it in for these Cardinals. Rosenbaum pressured there. Chirico getting it up, though. And Katrin able to keep that one in the Brockport zone, but not for long, as Rosenbaum brings it up with Tilly to his far side. Tilly trying to get around the net, but is met by two Cardinals. And the goal scorer, Bellina, takes that puck away, looking for Dodario. But Chirico, some great awareness on the defensive side for Brockport.
He was looking for that fast break, couldn't get it. Brockport, they're still trying to keep this puck out of their zone.
5 minutes left here. Brian Dickinson has to be considering pulling Weimer soon. Here comes Bolger skating in with authority, and Stockdale right on the doorstep and gloved right off the stick of Stockdale by Weimer.
It's the third period. Weimer still doesn't look exhausted at all. He has 43 saves right now. Can't he go for 50 saves in this game?
Yeah, nothing but rubber against Weimer, and he has been able to stop it. Yes, he's let in 2 goals so far, but an amazing performance.
An amazing performance indeed.
He has kept Brockport in this game, because this lead could be higher, as now it's Stockdale with Ring to his side. Here's Stockdale, and a call now coming, as Gates will be called for holding here.
Holding's the call. The great Gates has been took into the penalty box, and Gates, he is serving now, I believe. If I can find his name. Jacob Gates will be serving his second penalty of the year.
So with momentum seemingly on their side, Plattsburgh will head to the power play. Not what you want to see if you're Brockport head coach Brian Dickinson, and you're loving what you're seeing if you're Plattsburgh head coach Steve Muffin. So here's Hogg. Hogg getting it down to Jurasek. Jurasek back to Hogg. Hogg down to Breyer, back up to Hogg. Over to Weaver Vitale. Weaver Vitale looking to shoot, but decides to pass it up to Hogg. Hogg, Breyer. We have Vitale. Breyer. Just passing it around at this point, looking for an opening. Jurasek finds Weaver Vitale.
Wasting the clock as well.
Here's Hogg. Jurasek, his shot! It's stopped in front by Weimer. Minute 17 left to go on this Plattsburgh power play. 3:56 left in this game.
So correction to the Galloway penalty minutes. Galloway has served 2 penalties, so that gives him 3 penalties in the year, this year.
Ow. And so that puck hit up and out.
We got a little bit of Michael Jackson in here. Penalties really have been given up. It's been really an aggressive game that you have seen a lot of power play opportunities given to both teams.
Yeah, and that's, you know, and that's in part in a fact of both teams who are good at drawing power plays, and both teams who are successful on power plays, but here so far not much success. But here's Stockdale looking for Ring over to Bolger. Bolger now. That one hit off his stick by Harley, and the Cardinals have to reset.
No, and you're right about that. Both teams haven't been able to take advantage of these power play opportunities, and it's right now, can Brockport take advantage, or can the Cardinals take advantage? It's really both sides have been struggling.
Here's Daddario getting that over to Thomas. Thomas now leaving that for Stockdale. Stockdale moving in front, centering, but no one there. Here's Daddario back over to Thomas, up to Bulger. Bulger, his shot blocked out in front by Galloway. Ring now. 15 seconds left on this Plattsburgh power play. Ring. Holding. Over to Bulger. Bulger, his shot out in front. Almost getting into Daddario, but unable to get there. And so now it's 4-4 out in front. And this power play comes to an end. But Bulger and Ring shot out in front. Skips through the crease. And here's Thomas' shot. And that's blocked out in front by Gates.
My.
Now here comes Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum all by himself, his shot. And Schiller is able to get that one and put it out for Thomas. 2:19 left here. And these Plattsburgh fans are loving what's happening. And it scores on the empty net. It's Belgrave. And this one, signed, sealed, delivered. This game is yours, Plattsburgh.
What can you really say? You say pull the goalie, but that was not the right time to pull him. You had more time on that clock to waste, and Brockport did the mistake to pull their goalie too early, giving Plattsburgh an opportunity to score and pass this league up by two.
So a crucial mistake there by Brockport looks to have given the Cardinals this game.
And that's a momentum, like that's a heartbreak right there from the Brockport side.
That is heartbreaking.
For the Cardinals, at least they continue trying. Oh! No penalty call right
now.
No,
a penalty called, so we will have a delayed penalty here. So this game might not be over just yet, as Brockport will be going to the man advantage, and if they keep the goalie out, we'll be able to go on a 6-on-4 man advantage potentially.
But this is the thing that you have to understand as well. Even if you take your goalie out, you have to understand that this defense has been taking advantage of wasting power plays. Both teams have struggled to try to get a goal on power play, but for Plattsburgh, it doesn't matter really if you lose a man or not. They still play like they have full force on that ice.
And so Brian Dickinson decides to call a timeout here to see what he truly wants to do. But going to the box there is Joshua Belgrave, who just scored that empty net goal, and man, was he hype.
Oh, he has to be, because at the end of the day, you see a mistake taken from the other team, you take that mistake and you make it into an opportunity. And that's what the Cardinals did, boosting their lead up by two and also making this game almost an out of reach game.
Yep, it was out of reach. It looked like victory was within grasp for Plattsburgh, but now going back, they will be in the almost for the rest of this game, they will be down almost what will be for sure one man. They will be down, but it looks like Brockport will in fact keep the net empty. So Brockport, with a two-man advantage here on the ice, will have a minute 58 left in this game with six skaters, and that is crucial.
If Brockport loses this faceoff right here, they have to play a defensive game. If not, they will lose another point, and this game will be out of reach.
So it is being fought for down in the near end boards. Hogg just doing everything he can to just waste as much time as possible. But here's Brockport on the doorstep, and that one is pushed away by Schiller. And now another penalty coming here to Plattsburgh.
Plattsburgh really taking the penalty hits right now, and Eli just keeping that puck out, boosting up his save percentage for this game, and he's also really 17 saves. What can you really do?
Yeah, great save there. Schuler Flansburgh was on the doorstep, right? He only had Schiller to beat right in front of him, but Eli Schiller staying tout, staying strong, and denying
Plattsburgh on the doorstep.
Well, as we see a man down for Brockport, we all hope that he's all right.
And he is still down on the ice.
No. Right now, what we can really say, we hope he's all right. We hope he does get up from the ice right now. But overall, it's just really a pressure game right now for Brockport as they try to keep the pressure on with only 1 minute and 28 seconds left.
I'm seeing a bit of movement here. I believe down on the ice is number 91, Chase Maxwell. And you never want to see this, folks. So it looks like they're getting Maxwell to his feet now. And you never want to see anyone get hurt because at the end of the day, they're doing this for our entertainment.
Oh, of course. And it hurts when you see a player down and everything. And we're up here praying and hoping he's good down there.
Yeah, well, he did set up. Looks like the trainers will try to bring him to his skates now. And so Chase Maxwell, the sophomore out of West Hartford, Connecticut, we hope he's all right. Wish him a fast and speedy recovery. But we will get back to some hockey action. This game is not over just yet, as there is still a minute 28 left, as Brockport will still be on the six. They will be now on the 6-on-3 man advantage. So it is two players for every Cardinals player. And at this point, you have to do whatever you can. And that's a good start, as that is offsides. And so they will move that back into the neutral zone.
Cardinals right now is just really trying to waste time, as they're down a player for at least 5 minutes and down a player for at least 2 minutes. And it's hard right now.
Yeah, this has to be some of the best defense of these players' careers out here for these Cardinals players.
And for both power plays to really go on until the end of the game is really, it's a challenge right now for this Cardinal defense.
And so here's Harley getting it around, and no one out in front, and a great clear by Jurasek. So a minute left in this game. Here comes Galloway. Can Brockport get back into this one? Butler knocks the puck off his stick. And any time wasted is good time wasted for these Cardinals, as we've Vitali, great stick work there to get that puck up and out. Now here's Harley. Stops that one at the blue line. Gates over to Harley. Harley slapper blocked down in front by Vitali, but that shot off the rebound by Galloway is wide and around.
Another reset here for
30
Brockport.
Seconds left in this game. Brockport, they have to do something. It's now or never. Here's Flansburgh trying to get that one over, but it's Shredowitz with another great defensive stop the Cardinals have had here.
Now Trotowitz, great again. Trotowitz trying to get something down, and they will hit it as it's 10 seconds left in this game. A great defensive showing here. 6 seconds, trying to put this one away, and down three players. The Cardinals do not give up as they win this game. 3-1 here, and this crowd loves it. They are going crazy. This is a win for the Cardinals. They remain undefeated, moving to 5-0, 3-0 in the Suniac, and for the Brockport Cardinals, they lose this one, move to 2-3, 1-2 in the Suniac. Eli, what did you like from this one?
Whoa, it's just been a defensive matchup. You saw it from the first period to the last period. The Cardinals were just good defensively. Offensively, they did struggle, but overall, it's that third period Cardinals for you as they score two, untie this game, and keep their season undefeated. Mostly, an issue will be penalties and the amount of hits that really cost them a lot of players to take five-minute power penalties.
Yeah, and for Plattsburgh, like you were saying, this offense picked up in this third period. It was Spencer Belina who got that go-ahead goal, that crucial goal from the point. Wide open lane, could not miss on that one. And then it was Joshua Belgrave getting the empty netter. He was hype on that one. He was excited, jumping into the boards. And that one sealed the deal. And the Cardinals able to stay stout there at the end, having to go a minute, 30 seconds, 3-on-6. That is a hard, hard task to ask any team to overcome, and they were able to do it, Eli.
And it's amazing, too. They really showed that the Cardinals' defense is nothing to mess with, and for them to do a 3-on-6, Brockport had the opportunity, they had the advantage, and they missed it, and that's what you call good defense.
Yeah, and even though the highlight of this Cardinals team is their offense, this defense cannot be taken for granted, because this defense, if you think you're gonna get easy lanes and easy opportunities to shoot this puck, you're just dead wrong. They are going to make you pay.
Oh, of course, and especially when you have a good goalie, Eli Schiller, on your team, helping you stop those goals from coming in. It's amazing. He goes up 2-0 for the season, and it was just a good defensive game, and offensively, they did pop off in the third.
Yeah, but for Brockport, I think the spotlight, the shining star coming out of this game has to be Dylan Weimer.
Wow, it's amazing to say, but Dylan came here to work. Weimer came in here to save, and he came in here to improve his stats. Even though he did take the L for today, he came in here going over 40-plus saves, yes, in this game, and he's just boosting up his stat book, and his career is really looking good.
And yeah, any game where you save between 40 and 45 shots, even if you let two go in, that is a fantastic showing.
And especially against a number three ranked team, it shows that, hey, even against any other, even against the best, he knows that he has to save that goal.
And so your star's there, the second star, Eli Schiller, and your first star getting that game-winning goal was the defenseman, Spencer Belina. So, from all of us here at PSTV, I'm Hans Hummerschlag. This is Eli Perez. For all of our crew, everyone who works hard for us, John Chambers, Bruce Carlin, can't thank you enough. Thank you for tuning in, folks, and have a great rest of your Saturday evening. Thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you next time. Have a good one.